student. I'm going to be doing an examination today. Can I double check your name and date of birth?
Zach Washaba, 62486.
Hi, nice to meet you, Zach. So what we're going to be doing today is we're going to be doing an examination of your lungs, heart, abdomen, and extremities. So first we'll go through some basic questions and then we'll do the physical examination. Is that all right with you?
Yeah.
Okay, so to get started, I just want to go through a little bit of background with you. Do you have any medical conditions or diseases?
No.
Ever have any surgeries?
I had a double hernia surgery as an infant.
Inguinal or groin area,
yeah.
Or stomach?
Groin.
Okay. Do you take any medications?
No.
Are you allergic to anything?
Plastic Band-Aids and peanuts.
Okay. And do you have a history of any smoking?
About a half a pack a week.
Half a pack a week, okay. And has that gone up or down? How many years have you been?
It's gone way down. I've been smoking for a long while.
Okay, so you've been trying to cut back?
Yeah. I vape at home and then I chew at work because we can't smoke at work.
Okay, so you're using chewing tobacco, vapor, and also cigarettes a few times a day?
Less than a few times.
Okay, great. Yeah. And how much were you smoking at the height? Like a pack a day or how?
About a pack a day, yeah.
About a pack. And for how long? Like how many years?
Six.
Okay, great. How about alcohol use? Do you ever drink more than 14 drinks in a week?
Not very often, no. I'd say hardly ever.
Okay, great. And how about any other illicit substances? Or do you ever take any prescription that are not prescribed for you?
No, ma'am.
No? Okay, great. Are you having any complaints today? Anything? I see that you came in just for a regular annual physical, is that
yeah.
Right? Okay. So first I'm going to go through some symptoms before we do all the examinations. So for your respiratory system, do you ever have any shortness of breath? Ever feel like you're wheezing?
No, just random out of shape type stuff, but yeah, nothing concerning.
Okay. And how about coughing? Do you do a lot of coughing? Ever have any asthma sort of symptoms?
I cough occasionally. Usually it's because of the vapor or whatever, but yeah, I don't think there's anything I can think of aside from that.
Okay, and you're not coughing anything up, any thick mucus,
no.
Anything like that. Okay, how about cardiac? Do you ever get any chest pains?
No.
Any shooting pain through your back or arms?
No, ma'am.
Do you ever feel any palpitations, like your heart's racing?
No.
Okay, abdominal symptoms? Do you have any nausea, vomiting problems?
No, ma'am.
Any diarrhea, constipation?
No.
Ever have any abdominal pains?
No, ma'am.
Okay, good. And then we're going to check out your extremities, too, and check your circulation. Do you ever notice any discoloration or swelling to your legs or feet? Mm-hmm. Any sores that have trouble healing? Or any pains, numbness, or tingling in your extremities?
No, ma'am.
Yeah. Okay, great. So I do see that we have taken your blood pressure and your height and weight. Your other vital signs look good. Your blood pressure is a little bit high. We have you at 142 over 84, which is in the pre-hypertensive state. So we'll probably want to keep an eye on that. And your weight, height to weight ratio is a little bit high. You got a BMI, I think, was like 33.1 or 2. So that technically puts you in the obese category. So we're probably going to want to work on your weight as one of our goals. Would you be okay coming up with some sort of weight loss exercise plan to get you a little healthier?
Sure.
Great. Okay. So let's get started with the physical examination. So I'm going to talk you through each one. So just to provide for your privacy, I'm going to have you put your gown down about the waist area, and we'll do the top half of your body first. I'm just going to do make inspection from the front, see if everything looks symmetrical. Just take some nice deep healing breaths there. Good. Okay, so you seem to have a pretty normal posture, rate of speech, and you seem to be symmetrical on both sides. You don't see any deformities there. First thing we're going to do is have you sit that way a little bit on the bed, and I'm going to do a respiratory exam from the back. So if you just lean forward a little bit, take some deep breaths. I'm going to put my hands on your back, if that's okay. Okay, and then just take some deep breaths And I'm going to feel and see if your lungs are expanding normally. I'm gonna feel, palpate down the back of your neck and spine and just see if you have any tenderness here. Let me know if there's any pain in any of these areas. No pain anywhere there?
No, ma'am.
Okay, I'm gonna continue with the hand examination. The next one I want you to do is I want you to say the phrase 99 several times while I feel in your back.
99.
Keep going. 99. Great.
99.
Okay.
99. 99. 99.
Good.
99. 99.
Okay, great. That feels pretty even. Looks like you're resonating all the way through, so that's good. Lift up on my shoulders. Do you like a shift? Yeah, good. Okay, shoulder muscles feel even and symmetric. Okay, next I'm going to use my stethoscope and take a listen to your lung sounds. Oh, no, first, actually, I'm going to do the tapping first. So this is what we call palpation and percussion. We're going to do a tapping motion. It'll be like this, all on the back, okay? It shouldn't hurt. It feels a little weird. It just checks. Make sure you don't have any consolidation or fluid buildup. Sounds good. Now we're going to do listen with the stethoscope. Just take some deep, even breaths for me. Just a couple more. Great. Okay, we're done with the respiratory. You can sit back against the bed. Just go ahead and lay your shirt down here. We're going to move on to cardiac. So for cardiac, I'm going to feel your chest to find the spot where your heartbeat is the strongest. And then I'm going to listen over the chest and in your neck. For different areas of your heart and arteries. Now my stethoscope, it actually, it doesn't flip like some do to hear different sounds. It actually goes by pressure. So some areas I might push a little bit harder than others or listen a little bit longer. Okay, so first I'm just gonna feel for your heartbeat. To find the right spot. Actually, check this against your pulse, see if they're evenly matched. Sounds good. Down here, where? What is this target? Okay, that sounds great. So far, I don't hear any murmurs, but if you could just turn to the left just a little bit, about halfway, that helps me hear murmurs just a little bit easier. Next, I'm going to check your carotid arteries. Let's check their strength and check for any bruise, which would indicate that you're having some plaque buildup in there. Next, we're going to go ahead with the abdomen. So I'm going to do sort of the same as we did on your back. I'm going to do the tapping. I'm going to palpate and listen. And then it can be a little bit uncomfortable. Some of the palpation goes a little bit deeper. So just let me know if you're having any pain, okay? I'm going to lay you back a little flatter. Is that comfortable?
Yeah.
Okay, all right. Chris, I'm just going to take a look. Okay, the contour looks even, looks nice and symmetrical. Your umbilicus or belly button doesn't look bulged out. And I don't see any pulsations, which could indicate certain disease processes. Okay, so we're going to listen next. I'm going to listen all along the four quadrants, which is like the four sections here of your abdomen. And then I'm going to listen to some of the arteries underlying. So we're going to listen to your aorta, which is in the center, and then both where it branches out to your kidneys, which is called the renal arteries, and then where it goes a little bit farther down to your legs, it's called the iliac arteries. Okay, so we can do all that listening first, and then we'll move on to the percussion. Active and normal. Intestines are working. Right, anything abnormal in that big aortic artery? Okay, now the iliac artery is a little farther down. Do the tapping now. So I'm going to start here and try to tap around your liver, see if it's enlarged. That's normal for someone your age and healthy liver. I'm going to tap over here, try to listen for your spleen. Sound like an enlarged spleen either, so that's good. Okay, now we're just going to do the palpation. So a little bit of rubbing here. Just let me know if you have any pain.
You're good.
I'm just checking for masses, anything out of the ordinary. Okay, now a little stronger. Thank you. back up. We'll go ahead and put your shirt back on. Now we're just going to check your extremities. Just going to be inspecting them and checking some of your pulses. We're looking for any lesions, discoloration, sores, swelling. Squeeze your fingers, just check your the refill time it takes for your blood to come back in. Make sure your circulation is good. That looks good. And the other arm. Good. Give her a pulse. And good circulation. All right. We're just going to do the same on the legs. I'm just going to roll this up a little bit. Yeah, no swelling. You check your pulse here. And just roll the pulse and squeeze your toes the same as your fingers. Examination, so I'll go ahead and let you get dressed and I'll come back in and work on a health plan with you. Do you have any questions?
Nope.
Okay, thank you so much. Okay, so today I assessed Zach, who is a 31-year-old male. He was found to have a normal respiratory exam, regular tactile infirmities, no adventitious lung sounds, symmetrical chest expansion. His cardiac exam was normal. He had S1 and S2 normal sounds at all points. No signs of murmurs or extra heart sounds. No bruise in the carotid arteries. His abdominal exam was normal. He had no abdominal pain, no bruise in the aorta or iliac or renal arteries. He had positive bowel sounds, which were normal. No signs of splenomegaly or hepatomegaly. And his extremity exam, he had no signs of swelling, edema, discolorations, non-healing wounds. His pulses were within normal limits and his cap refill was normal. He was found to be at a high risk for cardiac disease due to his history of smoking, his pre-hypertension, and his obesity. So part of his plan will be a weight reduction and smoking cessation.